I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up next, we've got what should be a good one between the Chicago Bears and the Los Angeles Chargers. With that, let's get out to Dignity Health Sports Park in Southern California as we welcome in our guy, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, under hazy, overcast LA skies, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Dignity Health Sports Park in Carson, California. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Chicago Bears and our home team. Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Godden with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. They'll be led out by the veteran quarterback out of NC State. It's Phillip Rivers.
I'm actually old enough to remember him hitting the league, and so many people are talking about his throwing motion at the time. A little bit unorthodox. No one talks about it anymore except in admiration. The ball gets to the target really well and usually with big production.
Rivers out quickly here to Allen. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down. And the offensive starters here for Los Angeles.
I don't think it's hyperbole to say that Mike Pouncey is one of the best centers in the league. And to me, he helped usher in that new wave of centers. Agile, able to get to the second level and block people downfield, able to pull like a guard and get out in front of ball carriers, and pass protects really well. Helps keep his quarterbacks clean.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up,
D. On second and nine, Rivers finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Give him 12 yards there, and the Chargers have a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Wait, 89!
Here's a quick throw caught by Allen. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. And here are the Chicago defensive starters.
Ha-ha Clinton Dix attracted a lot of attention when he was about to enter the NFL for his ability to play the football in the air. He's actually shown that he can tackle pretty well in the league too.
They'll throw again, Rivers. It's complete to Williams. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 35. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however, they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 35-yard line. For Keenan Allen, that's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
Hold
This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and it'll be second and 12. First down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 23. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Rivers with a first and 10. And he's a perfect 6-for-6 here to start the ball game. Rivers to throw it. Complete. Hunter Henry with a grab. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
It's a game two. Brings up third and 5.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. Caught by Allen. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
Now that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close? Not their best play.
Badgley able to knock this one through, and the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. Able to move the ball on that drive. Yes, just 3 points, but 4 first downs were in there.
Yeah, and you can look at it and feel pretty good about the whole thing and think, okay, this should continue throughout this ball game. On the flip side, if you're a defender, it's almost like, whew, we only gave up 3. They moved the ball on us pretty well.
After the made field goal, Badgley back out there for the kickoff. This is fielded at the goal line. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. Do we get a peek at the former number 2 overall pick, Mitchell Trubisky? Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 24. Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And Charles, now we get our first look at this offense.
And one guy you have to look at in particular is Kyle Long. Can play guard or tackle with a nice degree of nastiness.
A 4 receiver look here. 3 out to the left, 1 to the right on 2nd and 8. Trubisky will throw. He'll have a first down past the 40. That's complete to the Memphis man, Anthony Miller. And he's going to get this to the 40-yard line. 14 yards into Chicago, first down.
And the Bears, first down.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky. Open man is Trey Burton. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Mark that down as a pickup of 13, and the Bears have the first.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner? Safety? Linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
First down, a run with Cohen. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Tackle made by Thomas Davis. The starters on defense here for Los Angeles.
It's real easy to talk about Thomas Davis coming back from multiple knee injuries, but he wants his play on the field to be the story.
Second down. It's Cohen. Oh, Cohen lost the football and picked up by the Chargers. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Ready. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Rivers now after the fumble recovery. He's got a man. That's Keenan Allen. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10, just outside the 30. Working out of the gun, Rivers completes it to Benjamin. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down LA. Passing in this first quarter. It's first and 10. Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon. He'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
From the 16, Rivers. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. To throw is Rivers. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25.
We're talking about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. He connected on his first, this from 41. Badgley's kick is good. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goals probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
After the made field goal, Badgley back out there for the kickoff. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing? Not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? The former Gamecock here, this is Mike Davis. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
So that one will be accepted.
Automatic first down.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive with a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown? But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
They'll run on second down with Cohen. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Six nothing, our score after one. They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Now Trubisky on first down, letting one go deep for the end zone. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
When offenses dial up big shots downfield, they're not always for the guys out wide. Sometimes they want to go to their big target, deep downfield, and the defense breathes a sigh of relief. 50-50 balls, not easy to get away from the big targets.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Trubisky gives to Cohen. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a third and 8 situation. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They go play action. Trubisky, he's got his tight end, Burton. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Try and run four with Davis. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. This will be play number 8 on the drive. It's third and goal. From the gun, it's Trubisky. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Maybe a little over-anxious in the pocket there. He just didn't look comfortable on that throw.
No, he didn't, because it wasn't his normal fluid delivery. And I think you might have had it right. Wasn't really confident with what he saw downfield and almost felt like he wanted to pull that one back.
Now for the field goal try. Here's Eddie Pinheiro from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. So if you like field goals, you've come to the right spot. We've had 3 so far.
But this is a football game, right?
It is.
You like that one, huh? You like where I went with that? How about that one?
I like it.
Okay, but hey, let's face it. In this game right now, both defenses have responded well. They're trying to hold the line on this. You just wonder if anyone can break through with a touchdown and put some pressure on their opposition.
So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. This is taken at his four. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yep. Run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Rivers on first down. Benjamin's got it. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Rivers, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Akeem Hicks at 6'5", 332, finds his way home for the sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put them on the ground.
So it's third and long for the Chargers and Rivers after the sack. Play fake to Gordon. Now Rivers. He's airing it out for Williams. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they have little chance of winning this one.
Fourth down and on is Ty Long to punt. Tariq Cohen is deep for the Bears. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bears take over. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bashed it.
Super toe.
Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. Now it's Trubisky. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Allen Robinson, the intended receiver. And it's third down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Draw play here, Trubisky gives to Cohen, and he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. Deep for the Chargers, Desmond King. Taken in at the 22. It's a net of 40 there. Punt of 48 and a return of 8. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they're about to come up on drive number 4, but so far just 2 field goals on drives 1 through 3.
Wondering if the head coach has talked with his offense coordinator and said, look, let's go ahead and press this a little bit. I'm giving you 4 downs on just about every occasion to try and get this offense kick-started and have it culminate in touchdowns. You know, maybe somebody to press it a little bit. This might be the case.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon.
Coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
On 2nd down, they'll run with Gordon. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And they're going to face a 3rd down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on 2nd down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. The Chargers on 3rd down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is 3rd and 4. Now Rivers. Open man, it's Allen. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger 1st down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure about the passer.
Now Gordon on 1st down. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That one good for 13 and a Charger 1st.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another 1st down with that run.
So into Bear territory now. This is 1st and 10 at the 41. This is Gordon. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Defense doing their job, really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it's almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense, no gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
On 2nd down, Eckler. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. The 2nd down play, not much better than the 1st, just a gain of 1 there.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
On 3rd down, Rivers. It's his running back, Melvin Gordon. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the 1st down. Now to be 4th and short.
So So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. This will be from 49 yards out. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And the lead will increase to 6 now. It's 9-3. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
After the made field goal, Badgley back out there for the kickoff. This is fielded at the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1, and that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
Trubisky brings the Bears up 1st and 10, just shy of the 30. From the shotgun is Trubisky. He'll buy some time right. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Now a throw here on 2nd down, and that's complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down. 1st down. First down now, but that clock rolling. Looking to throw, Trubisky on 1st down. Stepping up, he'll try and run. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be 2nd down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
And you can almost feel Trubisky saying, let's get to the line and hurry up. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Trubisky gets this to his running back, Tariq Cohen. Now the Bears going to call the 1st of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And this is Gabriel on the catch. Now the Bears going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. Now it's Trubisky. Robinson's got it. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And he's brought to the ground with another 1st down at the Chargers 17-yard line. Yeah. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. From the red zone now, here's Trubisky on first down. This one into the hands of Burton. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18.
Defense.
And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. Again, it's Trubisky. That is caught by Cohen. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Trubisky to throw again, and he completes it to Cohen. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No yardage to speak of whatsoever. Leads to a third down. So we have reached halftime in what's a six-point game at the break. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. Yeah, with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 27. Throwing here, Trubisky. That one brought in by his tight end, Adam Shaheen. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. On the carry, it's Davis. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1 yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Third and two. Now Trubisky. Able to find Shaheen here. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third. Well, they opted not to run it. They completed the pass on third and two, but they lost yardage to bring up fourth.
But give credit to the guys on the other side of the ball. They snuffed out the play. But it does bring into question, one, the play call, because they didn't run the ball there. They could have run it. And two, just not getting it. That's got to be deflating for them.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just two. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now we'll look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense,
we've got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done. He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now Rivers going to give to Gordon on the draw. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And it'll be third down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. Working out of the gun, Rivers. And that is incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him.
Here's Ty Long now, as he's on to punt for L.A. A nice little juke. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 24. Here's Trubisky to throw. It's complete. It's Miller.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Play action. It's Trubisky. Open man, Taylor Gabriel. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Trubisky on first down. He completes this into the hands of Miller. That throw good for four. It's second down. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Draw play. Cohen. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at six.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
On third down, Trubisky. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cohen. It's a pickup of 10 and a Bears first down. Trubisky will come up here first and 10, and he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Off the play fake, here's Trubisky. Gonna let one fly for Robinson, and that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail, second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Now Trubisky to throw. They'll find Miller. That's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7.
Let's go, D.
Looking to throw again, Trubisky. Completes it to Miller. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me, what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not, it's not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss 2 in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
They try the 50-yarder and miss it, and now this offense has it first and 10 at the 40.
We want it.
They'll try and get the ground game going. Here's Gordon. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The former Giant, Prince Amukamara, on the stop.
When you try to create space for your running back, the first thought is how physical is the offensive line. Sometimes it's just positioning. On that play, it didn't matter about positioning or being physical. The defensive front, they out-leveraged them and won the battle.
And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Rivers from the gun on third down. Completes it to Benjamin. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Here's Ty Long now, as he's on to punt for LA. The field now come the Bears. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Now it's Trubisky throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Trey Burton, the one he was looking for, and that'll bring up second down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. From the shotgun is Trubisky. Going to let one fly for Robinson. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly to sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Play fake to Gordon, now Rivers. Pressure and he's taken down, a bear sack. Akeem Hicks able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
That's his second sack of the game. The best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive lineman across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
Yeah. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. On the delayed handoff, this is Gordon. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
On third down, Rivers. Able to get this to Gordon. And he's got a first down and then some at midfield. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 43. Off the play fake here, Rivers. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way into the backfield.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
You got nothing with it. You got nothing.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score Chargers 9, Bears 3.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Throwing Rivers. Oh no, he lost the football.
I'm coming back.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Need something for deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the gun, Rivers. He completes it to Henry. Good defense holds him to only a yard and it'll be fourth down. First down would have been nice, but now you get to kick the field goal, still go up two scores.
They tried to get it though, didn't they? Threw the pass, got the completion just short of the first down, but you're exactly right. Run the field goal unit out there, kick it, put it through the post, go up two scores.
Here's Ty Long now. He's been terrific so far. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at the 20. From the gun, it's Trubisky. That is caught by Cohen. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less, as they come up on second and inches. Now Trubisky. Robinson's got it. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Out of the gun, Trubisky. He's got Burton here. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end could be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to account for him.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. Again, it's Trubisky. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Mark that down as a pickup of 13, and the Bears have the first.
Again, 13 yards. First down, Bears.
Trubisky will come up here first and 10, and he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Trubisky will throw. This one into the hands of Burton. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get a head of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Trubisky to throw again. Flush. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Joey Bosa picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
The Bears on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. Throwing here, Trubisky. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Joey Bosa getting him once again, his 3rd sack of the afternoon.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This from 54 yards away. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, just kicking a field goal there, that's a decision that could be open to second guessing. You know, you're trying to get back within a field goal, but it didn't work out as planned.
And now you're banking on your defense to be motivated enough to get out there and get the ball back for you. I think if that ball goes through the post, the defense is naturally motivated, even elevated in their mission. Now they've got to find a way to dig down deep and get it done.
Chargers in good field position to start out. First and 10 at their own 44. Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're second and one. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if you picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to second and one is probably better than picking up the first down, because in college football, the clock stops with every first down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. The Chargers on third down, not so hot. 2 for 9 to this point. This is third and 4. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. He's got a man, it's Williams. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Rivers now. 5 straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They go play action. Rivers. And that's incomplete. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Working out of the gun, Rivers. Got a man, it's complete. Williams. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 21. Big hookup there. Forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
Back to the ground now with Gordon. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. All you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
So it's Charger football as we welcome you back from the two-minute warning. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. This is is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. And Gordon's going to be stopped short. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Badgley able to punch this one through. And the lead stretches to 9. It's now 12-3. A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a 2-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now, because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
After the made field goal, Badgley back out there for the kickoff. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So now Trubisky and the Bears down by 9. 1:45 to play. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. The screen pass here to Cullen. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The Bears moving hastily into hurry-up offense. Throwing now is Trubisky. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. A gain of 6 there on first.
What a catch, and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them, don't they?
They get that little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game. That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Trubisky to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And he will score. Touchdown away. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
And now Rivers will lead the Chargers up to go for two. Following the interception here, Rivers. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. And there's a quick momentum swing. INT return for a pick six, and then the two-point conversion good.
And even if you're keeping your wits about you, you're thinking to yourself, okay, extra point block team going into the game now. All of a sudden you're hearing defense, everyone's scrambling for their helmets and throwing down their cups of water. That's a great position for them to be in, trying to score against that team. A little bit disjointed.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know, you just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once, we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Trubisky to throw. Pressure comes, and Trubisky goes down. Melvin Ingram dropping the hammer off the edge. So plenty of smiles for the folks here as they head for the exits. It's a victory for their hometown guys. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Southern California, so long, everybody.